you live in area where there is a risk to have a big rapidly rotating storm system called a hurricane approaching your area in every once in a while, then you should take some measures to help you survive or get through right out the situation better and maybe with smaller losses. Maybe the hurricane does occur only once in 20 or 30 years in your area, but in every case, if it's possible, then you should make some basic plans and preparations just in case. If you live in Caribbean Ocean area or in southern or eastern coastal areas of USA, then there is definitely a big risk to have a hurricane someday. If you're not sure do you have a risk of hurricanes in your area, contact your local officials for more information. You know, they should have information, is it a risk in your area and what to do or how to prepare for one. Of course, hurricane can enter further inland also, but as the hurricane feeds, so to speak, from the warm ocean, it will weaken and lose its strength eventually when moving away from the ocean. But it still can be a big risk. Maybe the wind is a little lower and there is no risk for storm surge, but rain can be still really harsh, so there can be extreme flooding, for example. So, what to do? How to be a little more prepared? Here are a couple of things to consider. But first I have to point out that this by no means comprehensive list or even recommendation what you should do. Always listen to your local officials, they should know the area and situation best. And always seek information from more than just one source. You know, not every advice or information you hear from the news or read from the internet is correct. So double check all the critical information from different sources. Okay, first of all, be aware of the situation. There most likely will be weather forecast saying that there is a possibility of hurricane in 1 to 2 weeks in your area, for example. So, after hearing this, follow forecast more closely. Hurricanes are not always easy to forecast in advance, and it may be only a few days earlier when it is certain where it will hit. Of course, when it seems likely that your area will be hit by a hurricane, it's hard to miss this news, but be aware. If you're not prepared for this kind of abnormal short-term situations, like the hit of a major hurricane most likely is, you should start prepare immediately when you hear these first warnings 1 to 2 weeks in advance. One of the first things to do is to make sure that you have enough food and water for your family. Go immediately to the grocery store and buy extra food and water for your family. You should have an amount that will last you for at least 1 week, because when hurricane hits, it's highly possible that the stores will not open. If they are open, they will be most likely empty, or there is no possibility to go there because of the flooding, for example. So, you cannot get food from the stores, or you cannot order pizza, for example. Normal services just don't work. Also, your local water service may not work and it can be contaminated, so you can't get water from the tap. So either buy water for at least for 1 week, or buy some containers and fill them with tap water. You may have seen these news from areas that have suffered from a hurricane, where officials are trying to distribute water with big tank trucks, for example, to affected areas, or are trying to send food somehow to people. Don't rely on these government supplies. They may never arrive, so you should have these storages of food and water yourself. If possible, buy food that does not require freezing or fridge. When hurricane hits, power may go out and stay out for a week or even longer. So this would make most of the food in your fridge uneatable quite fast. If someone in your family have medication, that he or she have to take. Make sure that he or she have enough of this medication to last at least for 1 week. To be on the safe side, medicines should last even longer. Make sure that you have first aid items available in your house, little more than just bandages. High winds of hurricane will make all kind of smaller and bigger debris fly, and they may hit you and cause a wound. They may hit your window and cause it to break, and fragments can fly inside the house and hit you. When hurricane hits the big city, trust me that the emergency services will not be available instantly, if at all. They are just too busy. And also, all the flooding could prevent them to even reach you. Also, your phone may not work, phone services may be down, so you can't call anyone for help. Because these have first aid items available and have, if not more, just basic understanding what to do if someone gets a big cut, for example. Some first aid training would be quite nice thing to have under your belt. Have a plan what to do. Should you stay at home when hurricane strikes, or should you leave your home and escape? And maybe stay at some hotel or with relatives far away. Have a plan for both options. You may not even have a choice. Officials may declare mandatory evacuation to your area and you have to leave. Do you just randomly start to drive then to some direction, or do you have a plan? I will get to this later on in this video. Ask yourself, is it possible for you to stay home? Is it worth it? Should you risk your and your family health when there is a big hurricane coming? You don't know what is going to happen. If it's going to break your house, it will break it no matter are you at home or not. You can't fight against the nature that much. Maybe everything will be okay, but why to take the risk? If you're close to coastline, storm surge will be a big risk. Basically, storm surge is an abnormal rise of water generated by the storm. This rise of water can cause extreme flooding in coastal areas. One of the best, or should I say one of the worst examples, is Hurricane Katrina. The storm surge was about 28 feet high. That's about 8.5 meters. So this means that water did rise 28 feet above the normal tide level. So expect to have this kind of storm surge. Is your home located in a piece of land higher than this? If not, then consider leaving your home if hurricane hits. Even if you're living higher than this or further away from the coast, there still can be extreme flooding because of the rain. Just a week ago, Hurricane Harvey produced over 40 inches of rain to some areas. That's over 1 meter of rain in some areas of Houston, for example. You can imagine what this will do. Land is not able to absorb this. Because of this, there can be suddenly water over 100 inches deep in some areas, even far away from the coast. Staying your home in flooded areas, it's not too pleasant experience and can be dangerous. If you live in apartment above ground level, well, at least then your home will be fairly dry, although lowest floor of the house will be ruined. Forecast may say that there will not be any considerable amount of flooding in your area, but you should not trust this too much. They do not know exactly what is going to happen and how much it's going to rain. It's just impossible to know. If you decide or are able to stay at home, then how to prepare your house? Well, there is not much you can do in a short time. For the flooding, there is not much that can be done. Huge amount of sandbags are not an option for most. To protect your house a little from the wind, you can buy plywood sheets, for example, and install them to your windows. This can prevent airborne debris breaking your windows. If there are big trees that could fall onto your house, consider to cut them down, or have someone to cut them down, for example. Like I mentioned earlier, power may go out, and because of this, it's a good idea to have a few light sources like flashlights available, and also spare batteries for them, obviously. Maybe some kind of lantern setup also. It will get really dark at evening and at night when power have gone out, so you may want to have these other light options. You can buy also candles, but these will bring fire risk, so you have to be really careful if you are using any kind of open flame inside your house. But they are cheap option and provide some light at the evening. Fire departments will be overloaded during the hurricane, so they most likely can't come to put down most of the fires. Because of this, you should have also some possibilities to put down the fire yourself, like fire extinguisher, and you should know how to use it. If you have a car, fill up your gas tank and keep it filled, and have a few extra gallons in separate containers available in your car. When hurricane hits, gas stations will run out of gas. Even if you don't plan to leave, have these available because you may have to leave. Or after the situation, it may take for a while before gas stations in the area are working again. Buy these items I mentioned earlier immediately if you don't have them. As soon as you hear these first warnings that a hurricane may be approaching in 1 or 2 weeks. When there is only 1 or 2 days left before the hurricane hits, stores can be empty, roads can be crowded, then it's too late to acquire anything. So have food, water, medicine, first aid items, lighting options, fire extinguisher, enough gas in your car available. Addition to these, also good supply of toilet paper would be quite nice. Also maybe some books, because it can be quite boring if power is out for many days. Some hand sanitizer could be also nice to have. If you have to escape from the hurricane because of location of your home, or there is mandatory evacuation, or you just decide it's not worth to take the risk, then have a plan where you're going in advance. And leave before anyone else leaves. This is the most important thing. If you have relatives living a few hundred miles away, ask if you're welcome to stay or book some hotel from a few hundred miles away. Don't just drive 50 to 100 miles and stay there. If you live in an area where millions of people live, there will be a lot of people doing the same thing, driving away and looking for a place to stay. So all the close by safe areas will be too crowded most likely. Also be aware to which direction the hurricane will move and plan your escape location accordingly. If you're living in southern Florida, for example, and hurricane is going to hit your area and is moving to north, it will not help you much if you move 200 miles to the north. You will be still in the path of the hurricane. So be aware, watch forecasts and listen to officials. If you have a car, it's quite easy to leave when you leave early enough. If you leave too late, you're not getting anywhere. Roads will be full and no one is moving. If you don't have a car, then do you have a family or friends who can help you? Leaving with train or bus could be impossible when big amounts of people are leaving. If you are living in some island and are unable to drive or travel away, then listen to officials and move to a safer place on that island, if that's possible. Just try to stay away from the coastal areas. Like I mentioned, try to leave before everyone else leaves. When a big hurricane hits major city, tens or hundreds of thousands or maybe even millions of people are maybe thinking to leave or have to leave. It's quite impossible to evacuate big amounts of people. When officials give mandatory evacuation order, it's most likely too late to leave. You have to leave, but doing that may be quite impossible. Roads are just not designed to take that amount of traffic. This has been seen many times in these situations. Freeways and roads leading out of the area are full of traffic and all the traffic jams. Freeway is jammed, no one is moving to any direction, you cannot get out even if there is an exit, because all the side streets are blocked as well. So people are sitting in the cars in the freeway and they are stuck, and they may be stuck for a long time, hours and hours. Most or some of these people just thought that it will be easy ride out of the city and did not take much of anything with them. Don't be one of these people. Think about the situation. The weather might be really hot. Sitting in a car on the top of the hot pavement will not be a pleasant situation. So I hope that you did bring something to drink. Most of the cars are idling because people are running their ACs because of all the heat. And this will eventually lead to a situation where gas runs out from most of the cars. This will jam the traffic even worse. Traffic may move slowly, but all this idling and moving slowly will lead to the situation when gas just runs out and you're not getting to location you want to get. You just don't have enough mileage left. There may be gas stations along the way, but guess do they have any fuel left when 10,000 cars have been in the same situation and have passed the station before you? No, they will be empty. They don't have any gas, they don't have food, they don't have anything to drink. They are totally empty. So I hope that you have those extra gallons of gas available in your jerry cans at the trunk. Also, obviously, when you're stuck at the freeway, there is no possibility to go to the bathroom, so only option is the side of the road. Not too pleasant either. Especially after everyone else have to do the same thing and are close by. I hope you did bring at least your toilet paper and some hand sanitizer with you. People are maybe getting sick. Sitting in a hot car is not fun or even doable for some. Having not proper way to clean your hands doesn't help either. So that will be a very serious situation and you don't want to be a part of it. Because of this, be aware and leave early enough. Leave before mandatory evacuation comes. You can always drive back if a hurricane did not hit. So if you're leaving by car, make sure that you take all the water you did bought or the canister you did filled with you. Take at least a few days of supply. Take all your foods you bought. Take some disposable plates and cups, etc. This will make eating on the road possible and much easier. Take also your medicines and your first aid kit, because it's a lot of easier to keep your hands clean on the road when you have some sanitizer available. Take a few days of supply of toilet paper and take the extra gas you already bought and make sure that your gas tank is filled when you leave and fill it along the way. Don't let it run even close to empty. Take also flashlight. It may come in handy if you have to spend evening or night at the car for some reason. Take a map of the area you're going to drive through. You may need to take a detour, for example. Having a map is quite important. Don't rely just some kind of a navigator you have. It may not work. Take also proper clothing with you, cause you may be away for a long time. It's a good idea to take a special raincoat and rain boots or something similar for everyone, cause you may have to leave your car and it could be raining, so this can be really handy. Also, take some backpacks or something similar. It enables you easily carry your items with you if needed. Also, take all your important documents with you or make copies of them and take copies with you. Same advice also applies to your family pictures. You don't want to lose those in a hurricane. I'm sure I forgot to mention something that I was thinking to mention, but I hope that this video was helpful for you. Stay safe. See you.